You know the feeling of standing in front of your bookshelf and feeling like some books are staring at you? Like, I'm sure you know this feeling. Just standing, looking at the books, and then you have some books that are just so much time on your TBR that they are looking at you. And those books want you to read them. Because I feel this feeling way too much. But there are some books that are staring at me, which I really, really want to read, but I'm scared to because of various reasons. So today I'm going to talk about those books that are keep staring at me, the books that I really want to read, but the books that I'm most intimidated by. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Jane and today I'm going to talk about the books that I'm most intimidated by from my TBR. Now all of the books are books that I really really want to read, but I'm afraid to read, and I'm going to share everything with you today and maybe it will help me to be less scared to read those books. This is what I hope will happen. So without talking too much, let's just get straight into the first book. And this book is a book that I already talked about a lot of times on this channel because I wanted to read this book for a long time. And this book is Girls of Paper and Fire by Natasha Nyan. And I'm actually going to finally read this book this month because this book is in my Desert on TBR. So this is finally the month that I'm going to read it and I'm really, really excited to read it. I'm just so scared, and the main reason that I'm scared to read this book is because this is a 5-star prediction and I do think that I'm really really going to love this book, but because I'm a mood reader, I'm really afraid to read this book not in the right mood. Like, I actually already started to read this book, like I read the first 5 pages and I just say to myself, no, this isn't the time to read this book. I was afraid to waste it, and this is the main reason that I'm so intimidated to read it. Like, I'm really scared to pick it up and I'm really scared to not love it as much as I think that I'm going to love it. Like, my expectations for the plot from this book are really high. I heard that the world building in this book is really good, and in case you didn't see me talking about this book in the past, this is about a fantasy world where each year 8 or 7 girls are chosen to be the paper girls and to serve the king. So this is like a very hard read with a lot of trigger warnings, but something about the idea just really makes me want to read this book. And I really hope that not only the world building, also the plot is really, really good. So yes, I'm just really scared not to read it in the right time and like to waste it. But I don't really need to be scared. Yes, I'm starting with this one because I'm finally going to read this one this month. And I'm really, really hoping to love it as much as I think that I'm going to love it. So yes, this is the first book that I'm intimidated by, but hopefully it won't be on my TBR after this month. Now, the next book is a book that is one of those books that I didn't see even one bad review on. I just hear only positive reviews on this book. It means that I'm going probably to love it. And this book is From Blood and Ash by Jennifer L. Armentrout. Something like this, I'm not pronouncing it right. But basically, this is an adult romance fantasy book. And this is a first book in a trilogy, I think. But the main reason that I'm really, really afraid to read it is because the length of the book. So the first book has more than 600 pages, which is a lot, and the thing that also the second and the fourth book are also really huge, and like I heard in a few places that although this is a really long book, it's so enjoyable, so it feels really fast to read. But also, if I will be reading it really fast, I need to commit for a long time for this book, and because I don't really have a lot of time, especially those couple of months which were so busy for me, I'm just afraid to commit to one really long book. And again, this is like a part of a series, but I do really want to read it. Again, I heard only good reviews about it. And also there is the bodyguard trope in this book, which is like one of my most favorite tropes. So I'm really looking forward to this one, but I'm really afraid from the length of the book. This is like the main reason that I'm really afraid to pick it up. But I do think that I'm really going to love it. I'm just afraid to committing to such a long time, especially because I personally love more to binge read series. So yes, I'm afraid from this book because it's so long, but I really want to read it, and I'm really hoping that I will have time to commit for such a long series soon, because again, I just heard amazing things about this book. Now, the next book is another long book, but I'm not afraid to read this book because its length. I'm actually afraid to read this book because I heard this is a very, very slow-paced story, and this book is A Knife House by Leigh Bardugo. Now, you probably know about Leigh Bardugo, also if you don't know about this book, which I don't think you don't know about, but basically, this is a dark academia book, and the story is in Yale University, which is so, so cool. Now, I actually never read a Dark Academy book before, at least not that I know of, but I actually really, really love all the concepts of stories in academic settings or stories in boarding schools. Like, I loved stories about boarding schools when I was younger. Like, I love this concept so much. So I really want to get into Dark Academia. And this isn't the only Dark Academia book in my TBR shelf, but I really want to get into this genre and like to try reading books from this genre because I feel like I will like it. So of course I picked Dark Academia books and Liberdogo, very popular author, but I know that this book is really, really slow paced. Now, this is also a long book. Like, it has almost 500 pages in this edition, but the edition is like huge. So in a paperback, it will be bigger than 500 pages. But this is the first book in a series, and like only the first book was released so far, so I'm not really worried about the length. I just worried about the slow pacing, because personally for me, it's really hard to read books with slow paced stories. And it doesn't mean that I don't enjoy any slow paced book. I do think that in a few books, the slow pacing is just perfect and so suitable for the story. But in this book, I just heard that it's really confusing, like the timelines. I know that there is more than one timeline and you can get really confused easily with those timelines. And also, like, a lot of people say that it's just so slow and like nothing happens, but I do really want to read it and I really want to enjoy it, because again, I do think that the concept of Dark Academia will be something that I would really enjoy. And also it takes place in Yale University, which sounds amazing. So it will be really cool to read something that takes place in Yale University, especially because Leigh Bardugo actually went to Yale University. So she actually learned in Yale. So she knows better how being in Yale feels. So yes, the concept of the story sounds really good. Like, this is supposed to be a mystery in this school, but I'm really afraid from the slow pacing. And I'm really afraid that it will be really hard to read and not really enjoyable because of that. So yes, I'm just afraid to read it because of the slow pacing. Now, the next book is actually two books that I'm going to talk about them together because I'm afraid to read them because of the same reason. The first one is I Will Give You the Sun by Jen D. Nelson. And the second one is All the Bright Places by Jennifer Niven. Now, those two books are like really short books. And this is like a contemporary romance story from what I know about both of them. And I heard really, really good reviews about both of the books. So like, basically it's supposed to be short, fun, cute read. But the reason that I'm so afraid to read them is because I'm afraid that my time to read them has passed already. Because from what I know about the books, and maybe I'm totally mistaken, but from what I know, it feels to me like the genre that is between middle grade and young adult. So I feel like those books are more for the younger crowd. And I feel like maybe I'm too mature to read them, because I personally find a lot of YA books recently not really mature and not really fun read for me anymore. Like, I do want to read more mature things and I do still enjoy a lot of YA books, but I personally not really reading a lot of middle grade because I don't find it as enjoyable as other genres. And like, I'm really afraid to read those books. I feel like maybe they will be like a waste of time for me because they are not as mature as I want books to be. Like, it's supposed to be emotional and cute, and I'm afraid to not feel those emotions because it will feel childish to me, if you know what I'm saying. So yes, I could be totally mistaken about those books, but from what I know from the people I saw that enjoying those books, from the main characters that I know that they are young, I'm afraid that I won't connect to the story as much as I could connect to the story if I read them when I was in high school or middle school. So yes, those books are just like, I'm debating if I want to read them or not because of that. If you read one of them and you can tell me your thoughts about them, it will be so helpful to me. So the next book is another book that I'm really afraid to read because this is a 5-star prediction and because I'm afraid to read it not in the right mood. And this book is Red, White and Royal Blue by Casey McQuinton. I heard just amazing things about this book. And now on the paper, it sounds the perfect book for me and like the perfect romance that I will definitely enjoy because this story is following the son of the president of the US. So it's a love story and it's also in royal theme. And I just heard amazing, amazing things about this book, but I'm really afraid not to read it in the right mood. Now, this is basically a contemporary romance story. I'm just afraid to read it not when I'm in a romance mood because I don't want not to connect to the characters. And I'm really afraid to read it in the wrong time and not connect to the story because I do think this story can be like definitely 5 stars bookshelves for me. I'm just afraid not to read it in the right time because I'm a mood reader. You can see it from the books that I already talked about. I'm afraid to read books not in the right time. Like, being a mood reader sometimes really sucks. I really want to read it, like, for a long time since I got it. Also, the book is like a fluffy paperback, so like, it feels to me so fun to read, and the copy that I have is so cute. I don't know, I just really want to read it, and I hope read it soon. Now the next book is the Colleen Hoover book. If you are not new to my channel, you know that I love Colleen Hoover so much, and I'm trying to read all of Colleen Hoover books, and one of those books is All Your Perfects by Colleen Hoover. Now this book, I'm afraid that it will break my heart, and I will tell you what. Colleen Hoover has this thing on me that she can make me cry in a second. Like, I cried from her books so many times before. I think that her writing just gets to you. And like, also books that I didn't think that I'm going to cry from, I cried and I sobbed in tears, because again, Colleen Hoover just knows how to make me cry. And now All of Your Perfects is a story that is following a married couple but is following their problems, and they want to get a divorce, so it's like supposed to be a really really sad story. So every other Colleen Hoover book that I read, I didn't think that it will be sad, that I will be crying. So this book, like, I'm 100% sure that I'm going to sob, so I'm just afraid of how it will break my heart. Just sounds like a really really hard story and really sad story to read. And I also read the first page when I tried to pick up which book to read next, and only the first page already made tears come to my eyes. Like, I already wanted to cry only from the first page. So I'm afraid to not be emotionally prepared for this, because I'm sure that I will just sob in tears from this book. So yes, I'm just really afraid that my heart will be broken, but I do really want to read this book, so I will probably just read it when I will be like in the mood to cry a lot. Colleen Hoover, I'm afraid that you will break my heart. So the next book that I'm really afraid to read is A Court of Thorns and Roses by Sarah J. Maas. The reason that I'm afraid to read it, it's because a lot of reasons. I feel like this is the book with the most reasons that intimidated me. So first of all, this is a very very hyped book. Like, you probably heard about this series. This is like a YA fantasy, high fantasy I think series. I'm pretty sure this is retelling of Beauty and the Beast, but I don't want to know too much before I get to this book, because I want to read it like more blind, because I love to read things without knowing the plot too much. But this is like such a hyped up book, and it feels to me like a book that I would really enjoy. So first of all, it sounds like a book that I would really enjoy. So yes, this is also a 5-star prediction. It was also in my 5-star predictions video, so I'm afraid to read it in the wrong time. And the last reason that I'm really intimidated by this book is because this is a very long commitment. You have 5 books in this series, but every book is like very long, and I'm afraid to commit to another series, but I really want to start this series. Just so many things together. 5-star prediction, so hyped up, like so many people love this series so much, and I'm just afraid not to read it in the right time and not to be enough emotionally prepared to read it. I'm just really hoping to love this book, and I don't want to waste it, and I really want to join the trend and also love it as much as other people love it. So yes, I'm just afraid to start this series, although I really want to, like, for a long time. Hopefully I will enjoy it and start it soon, like every other book that I talked about today. Now the next book is a new release that I was really really excited to read when I first got it, and I still didn't read it because it's a long book. But this isn't the main reason that I'm intimidated by this book, and this book is A Dark and Hollow Star by Ashley Shuttleworth. The reason that I'm so afraid to read it is because in the last time I hear only bad reviews about this book. Like, I see people give this book 1 or 2 stars non-stop. But this is a fantasy story about fae, and this is following 4 queer teenagers, so it's really cool to see the presentation. But this book is like, it's long, it has almost 500 pages in this really huge edition, so it's a lot of pages to read, and I'm afraid that it will be like a waste of time and that I won't enjoy it because I just hear only bad reviews about this book. So probably I also won't really enjoy this book as most of the people. It doesn't mean that this is going to happen, because maybe I will really enjoy this book, but I am afraid not to enjoy this book like a lot of other people. So yes, all the bad reviews just makes me not really want to pick it up and makes me really intimidated by this book. So yes, I'm already not sure when I'm going to read it, and as time passes I want to read it less and less because of those bad reviews. So yes, we will see what's the future for this one, not sure, but yes. So yes, those are all the books that really really intimidated me, and also also A Court of Thorns and Roses that I don't have a physical copy of. But yes, those are the books that I'm really, really afraid to read. And like you saw, I really want to read like most of them. So if you read one of them and like you have a reason why I need to be less intimidated by this book, please tell me, because I want to be less intimidated by all those books. I'm just really hope that I'm wrong, all of my fears, although I don't really think so. So yes, hopefully I will read them soon. I really hope to. I don't want to be intimidated by those books anymore. Yes, I'm uploading 2 times a week on Sundays and Wednesdays, but until the next video, you can check more videos by me. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye everyone!